everyone. I am Julie Jane Salomon, grade 12 magsaysay student from Mahayag School of Arts and Trades. I am going to report, to share, and discuss to you the different types of camping. But before that, let us define camping first. What is camping? Camping is an outdoor activity involving overnight stays away from home with or without a shelter, such as tent or recreational vehicle. Typically, participants leave developed areas to spend time outdoors in more natural ones in pursuit of activities providing them enjoyment. We have different types of camping: glamping camping, tent camping, backpacking camping, survivalist camping, canoe camping, RV and van camping, calling camping lover, and bike camping. Glamping camping. Glamping is also known as glamorous camping, and it involves camping with luxuries of home or hotel. You are going to find a wide range of glamping accommodations that are available all over the world, from staying in a yard on a mountain top to enjoying panoramic sceneries in an eco lodge. Glamping is more than a nice tent, as you can find varieties of options that range from cabins, villas, teepees, lodges, and treehouses. Tent camping. This is the most basic and famous type of camping all over the world. This involves heading to a park where you can pitch your tent where you will sleep for some nights. You can go tent camping on a campsite, a beach, in the woods, or anywhere you like. Tent camping is a great option to try out for people that are new to camping and wants to start without having to spend a lot of money. Tent camping is a perfect option for families with children, as it creates the chance to bond and learn how to work together. Backpacking camping. Backpacking camping mainly involves spending the day just carrying your gear and equipment on your back while you travel through nature. A backpacking trip can range from night to several months. Backpacking trip gives you the chance to spend time away from the hustle and bustle of your everyday life while you get closer to nature. Survivalist camping. In this type of camping, you will need to learn all the skills that you will need to survive in a variety of outdoor situations. In survivalist camping, you are going to hunt for food in the wild and also discover emergency medical treatments by yourself. By acquiring these skills, you will be able to survive in case of emergency or during harsh weather conditions. Canoe camping. Canoe camping is quite similar to backpacking, and you are going to get more freedom and lots of advantages of traveling by water. With canoe camping, you will not have to worry much about weight, as you can carry more equipment. You will also be able to travel further and reach places that are not accessible to hikers on foot or vehicles. Canoe camping is best suited for groups or two or more tourists in case there is an emergency. You can also go as a solo traveler, but you will need to make more preparation. It is also important to put rainfall into consideration during canoe camping, because the water flow can change easily. RV and van camping. Going camping in a recreation vehicle gives you the opportunity to enjoy fun outdoor destinations. With a recreational vehicle, you will have almost all that you have at home, and it includes comfortable bed and entertainment. You will also get the chance to park all the equipment and toys that you want wherever you go. All you will need is to find a suitable RV park where you can dock your vehicle. Calling camping lover. If you are an outdoor lover, you are going to find a wide range of ways to go camping based on your taste and preferences. All you need is to make sure you are fully prepared before you go camping. You will surely experience a once-in-a-lifetime experience that will linger in your mind for a long time. Bike camping. Bike camping is one of the most rewarding parts of cycle touring and bikepacking, but it can be intimidating, especially for beginners. Even as an experienced cyclist or an experienced camper, combining the two activities into one comes with its own unique set of challenges, whether you're heading out for a single night close to home or planning your first multi-state bicycle tour. A solid understanding of the basics is essential before putting the tires to the pavement. That's all for my report, and I hope you learn and gain knowledge about the topic discussed. Thank you for watching, everyone.